of America on 7465.
One of the top winners is about a squirrel and a very imaginative child, the other about trains. Deborah Taylor is a librarian at the Enoch Pratt Free Library in Baltimore, Maryland, who has served on several award selection committees. They're looking for the quality of writing, quality of storytelling. The John Newbery Medal for the most outstanding contribution to children's literature was given to Kate DiCamello for Flora and Ulysses, The Illuminated Adventures. This is her second Newbery Award, which is very rare indeed. Flora and Ulysses is a laugh-out-loud story about a squirrel named Ulysses and a girl named Flora in a world that is both real and pretend.
He uses that element of creating and getting inside the mind, the creative mind, the mind of a child that loves fairy tales. He can do that better than almost anyone.
Kate DiCamello is also the new National Ambassador for Young People's Literature in the United States. The Newbery Award and the ambassadorship mean she will be traveling a lot this year, talking about the importance of stories and reading. The Randolph Caldecott Medal for the Best Picture Book for Children went to Brian Slocum for his book, Locomotive.
It's simply stunning. So many different perspectives, so much technical joy without being overwhelming, still being child-friendly.
When you say child-friendly, what do you mean?
I mean, it's the kinds of things that kids would be interested in, like how to go bathroom on the train, being on a moving car.
When Brian Slocum learned he had won, he tweeted disbelief, joy, denial, acceptance. Kate DiCamello said, after I hung up the telephone, I started to think that I may have imagined the whole thing.
Okay, Voice of America on 7465. Today is 5 January 2014 at about 0140, I started listening to it, so. Okay, thank you, YouTube.